Lord, a hand clap of praise. Amen. Come on, you can do better than that. Come on, come on, come on. I know he's done something for you. Come on, he's done something for you. Well, come on, let me hear you then. Let me hear you. Amen, amen. We just thank God for each and every one of you being here. I'm not going to be before you too long, but I have to say this. I've been around music for a long time, and brother, you playing over there tonight. Yeah, you're playing. And young lady, I want to let you know, you're doing your thing. My wife is a drummer. And if I could say it like you was in the pocket tonight, I enjoyed it. I even saw the music kind of look back at her like you doing your thing. Look, let me tell you something. Playing in a skirt ain't no easy thing. My wife used to tell us that because we was at a church that she couldn't wear pants, but she could lift that little leg up, that little skirt up right there, and put a tennis shoe on it, man. She was in the pocket, amen. I just had to say that tonight. Come on, y'all give her a hand. Come on, give her a hand.
Amen.
Amen, amen. I also love when a girl can sing tenor. Oh man, yeah, when a lady can sing tenor, that's all right. But tonight, I am so excited to be here on this evening. I'm greetings from Freedom Church International Church, Christian Center in Buford, Georgia. I don't know if y'all know what Buford is, by the cow. Yeah, it's very far. Amen, amen. And so, food ain't good in Buford. You gotta come to Decatur and get some. But I am so glad to be here on tonight and to thank God for my brother being here with me, amen, Prophet Ernest West. Thank you so much for traveling with me on tonight. My wife, she couldn't be here on tonight, but she brings her greetings and everything. We have a 19-year-old, and I know we waited 10 years later and had another baby, and you know how that is. 10 years apart. You know, my older child was training him how to take out the garbage, and you know how that go. When you 10 more years, you out my house, and amen. Can I say that again? You know,
amen. Amen.
Train up the child the way they should go. Yeah, that's it. and everything. But I am here tonight to celebrate my brother in Christ. He's one of the most awesome pastors that I know. Can y'all celebrate Pastor Tony Lee?
Amen.
Amen. You know, I remember when me and Pastor Tony Lee had kids play boxes back in the day. Amen. I ain't jealous. He's got a little bit more hair than I have now. Amen. But that's good. We're still young in spirit. Amen. And I've seen Pastor Tony come a long way.
Oh, yes.
Come on. Let me tell you something. And Pastor, I know you can contest to this. It ain't easy having this mic and being behind this pulpit, because when you all go home and go to sleep, we're up praying and we're fasting. Come on now. And it's been days, if I could be real, we want to quit. Amen. It's been days I don't even want to come to church. Oh, come on. I'm transparent. It's something that I don't even want to come to church and want to preach. And then sometimes you don't preach all day. And because at the end of the day, you're either a wife, your husband, your father, you got to come home. And we deal with stuff too.
That's right.
You know, and sometimes we want to throw in the towel and everything. But I just praise God that this man of God has not thrown in the towel. Amen. Many people have come and many people have gone. And many people have lied to him and told him that they're going to come to church. They don't come to church. Do I got some witnesses out there tonight? Amen. And I am so glad that he is still standing. I don't know about you all. You know what? The reason he's still standing and you're still standing because you hang around eagles and not chicken. Oh, let me help you with an eagle. Let me help you with an eagle. See, an eagle don't hang around chicken. An eagle hang around his own cat. Okay. I'm not here to teach you a bird lesson tonight, but I know one thing I do know about an eagle. When a storm comes, first they say the eagle predicts the storm. And when those winds start to go crazy, he lifts up his wings and let the storm ride him to his next destination. See, I'm not trying to call you a chicken. I don't want to get a phone call that you're trying to sue me for calling you a chicken. But I don't hang around chicken because chickens run when a storm comes. I'm glad tonight I'm hanging around an eagle. Somebody that wants to continue to preach this gospel even when nobody don't show up. I know one time, man, he was preaching one time, then one person showed up, but he still preached. It's like thousands was in the building. I remember one time, ain't nobody show up for church one Wednesday night. I was preaching and nobody didn't show up for church. And I was at a community center and nobody didn't show up. And even my wife and I couldn't make it that night. So I'm talking about nobody didn't show up. And I almost got discouraged. And I started preaching. And God reminded me that when you was 5 years old, you would pull chairs around the side of the house and preach to the chairs and declare that people are going to sit there. And that's what I started to do. And I've seen this man of God preach the wallpaper off. And regardless of what went on, he still moved forward. Sometimes people told him, you just need to just go ahead and shut the church down for a while. You need just to just leave it alone and maybe move to something else. But he got the calling of God on his life. I need to encourage you tonight, regardless of what people say and what God told you, is for you. And you need to keep pressing. I got a scripture I'm going to read tonight. And I'll probably be out your way. It says in Philippians 3:13-14, it says, brethren, I do not count myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do is forgetting those things. Say forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to that things which are ahead. I press towards the goal of the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. I don't know about y'all, but your next blessing is going to be in the pressing. Oh, come on now. I don't know about you all. I'm going to press through until I know what God has for me.
Amen.
I told somebody the other day, if you want to leave, they said, well, you know what? We didn't do that at my bishop church. We didn't do that. You know what I said to them one day? I ain't scared to tell them. I said, maybe you need to go back to your bishop church. Oh, come on now.
Amen.
Oh, I told one lady one time, she was the biggest giver in our church, but she felt like she could control everything. I said, baby, this church ain't for you. See, when they realize that it ain't all about them, it's about God, you can continue to stand forward. You can continue to press. So, man, I declare in the atmosphere that seats will be filled, not because of what men or trying to show off for the men, because the Bible says if we lift him up, he will draw all men.
Yes. Amen.
Yes. Let me tell you something. People losing their faith day by day. And I come to realize if one show up or five show up, I'm going to give my best.
Amen.
We got to stop being so concentrated on how many numbers showed up. I don't even ask my wife what is offering anymore. And stuff, because you get your mind all clouded. I feel like this. Whoever came to church, it was meant for you to come to church. And whenever offerings came to the church, it was meant to come to church. But I tell you one thing. The house of God should not be lacked.
Amen, amen.
It is no shortage in heaven. Oh, am I saying something like, it's no shortage in heaven. And I truly believe if I don't have nothing, I still got something. I got God.
Amen.
And Pastor, I want to let you know that regardless of what goes on and what people say, I just...